Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We'll be right back. Thank you. was in there. Now, let's get this door open. It's a special door, you know. Only the people of Alexandria know how to open it. Go on, give it a try if you don't believe me. See? Told you. Only Alexandrians know how to open this door. This is an emergency, so I'll show you how to open the door. But you have to promise never to tell anyone. Okay, here we go. Open Sesame! Pretty cool, eh? It opens from the bottom. Well, this is as far as I'm going. I'll head back to the village now. You help Jessica.
You'd be back for the jewels. You killed my brother. Now you'll suffer the same fate. You're fast. I guess thieves need to be quick on their toes. But you won't get away from me this time.
Wait! Jessica! It's me! Don't you recognize my voice?
Alistair?
Stay your spell, Jessica. I wasn't slain at their hands.
Stay my spell! But it's too late! Alistair? Alistair? Is that real?
It's me, Jess. You have to listen to me, as do you travelers. After I died, a part of my soul was allowed to linger in this statue. Even now as I speak to you, the power keeping me here begins to evaporate. Time is short. Look into the statue's eyes. The truth lies within. Hurry! The day I died, the door to the tower was already open. I thought it was strange, so I decided to look around and see for myself. That's when I saw him. Who are you?
Such a pity.
Pity? What are you talking about? Who are you? Answer me!
Me? I am Dul Magus, and I was referring to the fragility of human life.
Fragility? What do you mean? My sword! I can't draw my sword!
I said such a pity. A terrible pity that a shining young star like you should chance to encounter me!
What have you done to me? Dul Magus, I won't forget this.
What? You won't forget my name? You're too kind. I shall return the favor and remember yours as well. Now, let us finish this before I feel any more pity.
Dul Magus!
It has been an honor making your acquaintance. You may rest assured, your death will not be in vain.
And now you have seen what the statue saw, my traveling friends. I don't understand it myself, but it seems the statue of Alexandra has been awaiting your arrival. If the memory of my tale can serve you on your quest, it would bring great relief to my soul. My stay here is coming to an end. It's time for us to part.
No! Alistair! Don't leave me!
Oh. One final thing, Jess. Mother may try to stand in your way. Nevertheless, follow your heart and do as you must. Farewell, my little sister.
What a tragic affair. There can be no question. This is Dol Negus's treachery.
Cool, blimey!
It would appear that Alistair also wishes us to bring Dol Negus to justice. His sacrifice shall not be in vain. Now, we have yet another reason to stop Dol Negus's foul reign of terror. I shall await you by the carriage. Cheerio!
I really must apologize for my behavior. We'll talk more later, but I need to be alone right now. I'll see you back at the village.
Family matter. The lady will attend to you shortly.
I'm going to ask you again, Jessica. Are you entirely bereft of compassion? Will
you not mourn your own brother's death?
Not this again! Of course I'm sad. I can't believe I even have to say it. But all you can think of is tradition and family obligations. I'm talking about avenging his murder!
Avenging? You will stop this foolishness this instant. You are a young lady, not a warrior. Do you really think Alistair would have wanted this? You will mourn your brother's death like a proper lady. It's our family's way.
Our family's way? Who cares about our family's way? I don't expect you to believe me, but Alistair spoke to me. He told me to follow my heart. That's why my mind is made up. I don't care about the consequences. I'm going to make Alistair's murderer pay.
Very well. It's obvious there's no talking to you. Do as you wish. But, as far as I'm concerned, I no longer have a daughter. I want you out of this house at once!
Fine! I was planning on leaving until you came to your senses anyway! Bangers! Mash! Let me through! I'm getting my things! I'm sorry for not telling you the truth before. Forgive me.
Are you really leaving, Jessica?
Yeah, I am. And I want you two to watch over the village while I'm gone. Alistair told me this would happen. He said you two would protect the town and grow up to be famous warriors. Come on, chin up. Your mission guarding my room is over. I want you to patrol outside from now on.
Yes, sir!
Well, I'm leaving. Thanks for being such a great mum. Have a nice life! Thank you.
Thank you.
Time to argue. I want you to put out to sea now.
My apologies, Miss Jessica, but the waters are simply too dangerous at the moment.
Haven't you been listening? I told you I'd take care of that.
Please forgive me, Lady Jessica. There'd be hell to pay from the Albert family if we put you in danger.
Is there anyone around here with half a brain? Ah, speak of the devil. You're the travelers from the tower. Didn't I tell you to wait for me in Alexandria? I wanted to properly apologize to you. Well, whatever. I'm glad you're here now. Actually, I have a favor to ask. Would you mind coming over here for a minute? So,
You're saying you won't let me fight the sea monster?
Well, yes, but... what I mean...
Fine, fine. Not to worry. I've asked these sturdy men to take care of it for me. Okay?
Oh, well. Actually, we've been looking for someone to take on that very job ourselves.
Well, there you have it. Everyone's happy. Can I count on you guys? I knew I could count on you. I still can't get what we saw in the tower out of my mind. Who is this Dolmagus? And what does he want? And why did he murder my brother? I'll track him to the ends of the earth. But first, we've got to make the waters safe for ships to sail. The sea monster that's standing in our way is supposed to be pretty strong. You'd better be prepared. I'll be waiting here. Come back as soon as you're ready.
Thank you.
Are you ready to set sail? Okay, then. Quartermaster, prepare the ship!
Aye, aye, sir! Prepare to set sail! Weigh anchor!
No, I hate your tootickles! These nasty humans and their ships! Always sailing over poor Calamari's head!
Yeah, Tenta, yeah. Humans don't have no manners.
That's ridiculous! They don't have none at all, they don't! No!
That's why Calamari's gonna stand up for all the poor creatures of the sea. Starting by eating these here humans.
Yeah, Tickles, yeah. He'll eat him. Eat him right up.
Thank you. They
were stronger than we thought.
We give up!
Sure, it wasn't our fault, though. It was his.
That's right, it was.
That jester, he came walking on top of the water to us. Just walked over us. He did. Pretty cheeky of a human to pull that little trick off, we thought.
So we talked to him, we did.
But when he talked,
our head got all cloudy-like, and we started attacking ships.
We did. It wasn't us. It was that jester. It was.
Is this by way of an apology, like?
Oh. We found it in the ocean. We did.
Go on, take it, man.
It's the least we can do.
Well, that is all from us. We are leaving now. We are. Have a pleasant trip. So long.
Not bad, guys. You're a lot stronger than you look. You know, we've never properly introduced ourselves. I'm Jessica. Jessica Albert. And who might you be?
I'm Yangus, and this here's the Gov.
Yangus and the Gov, is it? Right. Thanks again for your help with the sea monster. Now, let's find Dormagus. I'm sure you need to get ready first, so let's head back to Port Prospect. I'll tell the captain to weigh anchor. Oh, I almost forgot. I called you two thieves back at the tower, and I never formally apologized. So, forgive me. Anyway, I'll talk to the captain.
All hands on deck! Weigh anchor and prepare to come about! We're heading back to Port Prospect!
We took care of the sea monster, so I got them to agree to wait for us. I figured you'd like to rest and buy provisions before we set sail again. I'll be waiting for you here. Don't take too long now. We've got work to do.